Kolbrin Bible, Book 5, Chapter 33, Speculation, Part 8. The whole chapter might retell the myth of Osiris, Isis, Horus, Set, but the name of Isis doesn't match. MAN 3311. In the early days, Egypt was bounded in the west by the green, bitter waters. There lay the land of Nalar, where men learned to bend the dead bodies so that the earth-bound spirits of departed ones should not wander to molest them. Out here was the city of Moreau, from whence came the mighty men who smote the giants in the days of yore. Northward lay the entrance to the kingdom of darkness under the earth. The portal lies behind a veil of air mixed with water. It is covered with a mantle of cloudy thickness, which eyes can scarce see through. The floor is of water, not too deep that the dismal stony bottom cannot be seen. Hence, men require a boat. Both sides of the entrance are flanked with giant blocks of stone, from which rise huge pillars, set one against the other, so that there is no space between them. The whole is overset with an immense rock greater than any cut by mortal hands, and it is shaped like the rump of a man. It is in a cold region of long darkness, where the calf of gold shows his displeasure. Now to the west of Egypt, all is barren and sandy, except to the north, which is the habitation of wild men who dwell in holes within the ground. 3311. Could Moreau be a reference to one of the two lands of Upper and Lower Egypt? I was thinking the Nile Delta region, since it says bounded. That would seem to imply surrounded. Yet Moreau is a city that was a capital to the Kushite kings. It also refers to northward, a kingdom of darkness lies behind a veil of air mixed with water. Mist, maybe? The floor of water that men required a boat could be a reference to the Mediterranean. The rest I am unsure of. Two stone pillars. I'd like to say Stonehenge, but that's a huge leap. I'd also like to think of the Straits of Gibraltar, but where would the stone pillars be? West refers to the western desert, mostly rocky in the north, but there is an area referred to as the Great Sand Sea that is not rocky. Could reference to men who dwell in holes within the ground refer to people that lived in caves? This part I add from a site to show bodies have been found bent. The oldest known skeleton in ancient Egypt was discovered in a burial site referred to as Talasmasa I, close to the Temple of Hathor of Dendara. The body of an anatomically modern child was found, which was dated to around 55,000 years ago, Pleistocene age. The body was seated with its legs bent to the left, leaning backwards in an east-west orientation. Nazlit Katur, an upper Paleolithic site near Tihata in Upper Egypt. Archaeologists discovered two graves, tentatively dated to 30,000 to 35,000 BC. One grave, the body was clearly placed on its back, knees bent, held tilted to face the west. The left arm rested on the pelvis, the right stretched along the body. This is the link I got for the information.